Alrighty, so welcome back to the playthrough of Super Mario RPG for the SNES by That One Gamer. So, we reached Land's End, we played a mini game, and now we saw a little cave over here. So now it's time to start exploring. So, jump in, wait for the cloud to appear, and then you can hop in. Got a bunch of geckets over here you can bypass just by jumping over. Get this treasure chest, stand here, and press directly left and jump to get it. Now thinking about it, what experience do we have? Bowser still has the most. Ah, let's fight him. Okay. Boom! Confused monster. Ooh, he's confused. They hit each other. I love it. Like the Three Stooges. And usually after Mallow, it'd be their turn. It'd be the Gekka's turn. Wait, okay. Gino, never mind. Next time, we'll show that they would have bypassed their turn. Maybe not. We'll just Geno Blast all these guys. Rainbow Blasts. Bye! Okay. I'll fight Chao. Let's do another Geno Blast. Boom! Ha! Even has enough to take out the Shogun. Those guys have 150 HP or so, and do a lot of damage. Okay, I'm going to switch out experience booster here. You can see those little mushroom things, but you can never get any actual mushrooms from them. And now, do you recognize this room? Knock the barrel down. Hey, look at this. That's the guy that said, this is a dead end. That was from way back in Kero Sewers. You could fight him way back then, but I wouldn't recommend it. Shy aways? Oh, you would have gotten yourself green. One really worse would have killed you easily. And by then you only had Mallow and Mario. So. Ah, I love it. You would have had to be lucky in order to survive. Ribbite here, even though he has low physical defense, he still barely would have done triple digits, if that, in a weakened condition back to level 5-6. Look at that. Get no experience from those stupid shyaways. Again, here we are, back at Kero Sewers, Cricket Jam. While we're here, go back out here to Tadpole Pond and give it to our friend Frog Fuchsius. Yep, Cricket Jam. And frog coins. Whatever that first melody thing. Oh, thanks. All the world's a good egg. So even if him, one thing point you ever get stuck, just talk to old man Frogger. Frog Jesus. He'll give you a hint. Anyway, back to Land's End we go. You have to go repeat a little bit of the sections, but nothing too terrible. Up against the wall there, you make it much easier to get through that. Lucked out on the speed there. Alright, now if you jump down here without talking to him, you'll automatically be in normal course, and that you automatically are fixed in your jumping distances. Donut blocks don't fall. And, hey, mouse. And, hey, we don't go to battle phase. And we talked to him. He's one of those reformed monsters. Yep. What if I say no? Okay, so these walls just take you either the left or right rooms over here. Doesn't matter which one you take. Just look for the. If you would have said yes to going to Monstro Town, it said just follow the ant in the Whirlpools. It's impossible to proceed until you fight them first. In this case, you either use Gino's Gino Beam or Malo's Snow. Either way, you get relatively the same amount of damage you want to do. I actually saw Snowy. 222. Mario leveled up. Oh, just plus 2 attack, really? Come on, man. Well, after you defeat it, you'll notice the worlds move a little bit fast, so you have to wait for it to go. Actually, I want to go back to the other one. I'm not sure if fight all of them. Snowy did 222, but what did Geno Blast do? 202. So a little bit weaker to the ice attacks rather than the Geno attacks. Crusher! Rock type attack. Really? 2? Come on, man! Shogun was actually the name of a feudal lord back in the feudal era of Japan. I think the first feudal lord, the Shogun, came around like, what was it, 1500? It was like 500 or 1000 years after the first samurai, which is back around 500 so AD. I remember learning that back in my high school. For some reason, that stuck with me. I don't know why. The word samurai means to serve. Oops, lost that. Notice once you've already fought the ant, touching it will have him jump up, but then Mario quickly retreats. This one, the worlds move around. He changes places every now and then. Can I get higher than 222? final token leveled up. Mute. That makes the enemy unable to use magic attacks. So almost any status effect that they can give you, you can do the same in return. I think an exception is the Scarecrow effect. Hey, what's up here? Hey, it's you again. Oh, see ya. Climb here. Oh, I can't fight any of these green things. So much for that. Okay. Let's see, who had the experience thing? Oh, the toads do not use it. As another thing, if you manage to jump on top of these shoguns 3 times in a row in those whirlpools, you'll get each jump will give you a coin every time you successfully land on its head. First two are 10 coins, but the next one is 244. Boom! The next one is a frog coin, so it's another place where you can really accumulate those frog coins. However, it's best to do it on those whirls where they're circling slowly, those three whirls. But for now, I think I'm gonna stop it right here. Let's see, make sure I got the next person on save thing. I'll leave on Kero Sewers this time. I'll leave it on her. And we'll continue on through, try to get to Monstro Town, and get that star that Mouse was talking about, so. We'll see you all next time.